Online subscription fees may head higher soon as President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. signs into law an act imposing a value-added tax on foreign digital services. Marcos says a new tax law could generate up to 100 billion pesos in revenue for the government. So details from Pierre Gutierrez.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Wednesday signed into law a measure that imposes a 12% tax on foreign digital service providers, such as Netflix, iTunes, Spotify, and HBO Go. The Philippine leader signed Republic Act 12023, or the Value-Added Tax on Digital Services Act, one of the administration's key priority measures, during a ceremony in Malacañang attended by government officials and lawmakers. The law covers digital services such as online search engines, cloud services, digital ads, e-market platforms, and digital goods. However, online courses, webinars, and other digital educational services will be considered VAT-exempt, as well as the services of banks and non-bank financial intermediaries. The government, however, clarifies the law does not impose new taxes, but instead strengthens the power of the Bureau of Internal Revenue to collect taxes on digital service providers, or DSPs. It is also expected to level the playing field for local DSPs and their foreign counterparts. This is because before the enactment of the law, only DSPs based in the Philippines are required to pay the 12% VAT, while non-resident DSPs, or those that have no physical presence in the country, enjoy a tax advantage, even as they profit from Filipino consumers.
If you are reaping the rewards of a fruitful digital economy here, it is only right that you contribute also to its growth. After all, whether you are a small tech startup or a global tech giant based halfway around the world, if you are making money here in the Philippines, you are part of our community. And with that comes a shared responsibility.
The VAT on Digital Services Act is expected to generate over 105 billion pesos in revenues for the government in the next 5 years, 5% of which will be allocated to the local creative industries.
This means our artists, filmmakers, musicians, the very people who fill our platforms with stories and with content, will directly benefit. It ensures that our creative talents are not just surviving in a competitive digital market, but will be allowed to prosper. Fairness, inclusivity, and progress.
The Bureau of Internal Revenue, meanwhile, welcomed the enactment of the law.
This law promotes fair competition, ensuring that both local and foreign DSPs compete on equal footing. And in doing so, we create a more competitive marketplace where consumers will ultimately benefit from improved services and fairer pricing.
But should Filipino consumers now expect an increase in the prices of digital services?
So as to whether magkakaroon ng price increase, no, it doesn't necessarily follow. Of course, it would also depend on the, it's a business decision by the service providers.
Meanwhile, Lumagi warned that non-compliant digital service providers may be suspended or blocked through the agency's online Candado program. The BIR says it will start imposing the VAT on foreign DSPs 120 days after the effectivity of the laws implementing rules and regulations. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
Saudi Arabia hoping for de-escalation and dialogue as tensions once again escalate in the Middle East following Iran's missile attack against Israel. During a conference in Berlin, Saudi's economy minister Faisal Al-Ibrahim described the recent escalation as unfortunate, but hopes wisdom will prevail in the situation.
And it's unfortunate, the escalation that we've seen. However, looking at the global economy as a whole, looking at our region, it is clear that we are operating below our potential. And operating below your potential is operating at a loss. And I think we can't afford to operate as a global economy or global community at a loss, especially with the advent of many crises and sometimes happening at the same time. The kingdom's position, of course, is one of de-escalation and of dialogue and of resolving these challenges. Mainly because this is something that's regional and is in proximity to many countries that want to see a more prosperous future.
The United Nations Security Council has scheduled a meeting on the Middle East conflict this Wednesday. Ireland unveils a bumper 2025 budget, all thanks to a 14 billion euro tax windfall from Apple. Finance Minister Jack Chambers, who called a tax windfall transformational, said government is planning to invest the money in housing, energy, water, and transport infrastructure. The Irish government is set to approve a framework for the spending in the first quarter of 2025. Apple last month was ordered by EU competition regulators to pay 14 billion euros in back taxes to Ireland as part of the bloc's crackdown against sweetheart deals between EU countries and multinationals.
The local IT BPM industry bullish about growth in the Philippines. At the 16th IT BPM Summit, IBPAP President Jack Madrid said their group sees industry revenue climbing 7% to $38 billion by year end. According to Madrid, the sector is at a transformative time as the use of generative AI rises. He admits the technology will affect jobs, but for now, it has not negatively impacted the industry yet. He notes 67% of IT BPM companies are already using artificial intelligence.